Hey, everyone. It is Stephanie. We are back again. I am kind of in a hurry today because I've got to get my kiddos from school in about 45 minutes. So I don't have much time today, but I've been sitting here mixing paints for so long that I don't really want to wait until I get home to do this piece. Plus, it's quieter if I do it while the kids are at school. But I don't know how this piece is going to turn out either, so we'll see if this video makes it to YouTube. But this is a piece that I am super inspired to do by Sarah Taylor. I know you guys have heard me talk about her before. Her link will be in the description again this time. If you do not already follow her, go check her out. Her work is amazing, and I promise you guys will appreciate her art and love what she does. She does very modern pieces that just blow my mind. So this piece, ever since I started watching her, one of the first pieces of hers that I saw was a piece that she called Gumtree. And I have been in love with it. I've been in love with it so much that I've watched the video so many times that when I go back to watch it again, it's like not at the beginning of the video, it's somewhere within the video. So I just rewind back to where she's pouring the paint and watch the rest of the video. So I didn't even know that it was a piece. I didn't remember that it was a piece that she did as a commission, because like I said, when I go back in the video, I don't go all the way back to the beginning. I just go back to where she starts painting, because she shows like the colors and the paints that she uses and stuff. So I don't go all the way back to that. I just listen to her and watch her do the painting. So I messaged her last night and was like, was Gumtree a commission you did? Because if she still had that painting, I was going to buy it from her, because it just speaks to me for some reason. And I've watched her do it so many times. So anyways, short story long, she doesn't have the piece. It was a commission that she did for a customer custom piece. And I just love that piece. So I'm trying to kind of do, I don't have the exact colors that she used, so I can't try to replicate it exactly, but just the style that she does and the results that she gets, I want to see if I can replicate something similar, just to see if I can do it. So that's what we are doing. So we'll give this a go. We are working on an 11 by 14 canvas, and this is just the puddle paint that I am, the base paint that I'm stretching out across the canvas. And this is our bare satin enamel paint that will hopefully give us some beautiful pearls in the painting, in the piece. And I keep feeling like it's just not thin enough, but I mix it and it doesn't puddle for me at all. So I'm like, it's gotta be thinned down enough, but it's just not stretching how I feel like it should be. But let me get this stretched out over the canvas, and then we'll get going with some colors. Like I said, I feel like I'm not gonna have enough time to really go into the painting and do some of the detail work that she does on her paintings at the end. Which again, I'm not making an exact replica of it. I just want to make something, if I can, half as beautiful as her pieces. So we'll see what we get. We'll see what we can do with the time that we have. Okay, now let me see if I can get this to stretch down to this side, or if I don't have enough on here. Here we go. It's coming down there. Okay, well, one thing I know is that we've definitely got this stretched out on here really good. I don't know that I could stretch it anymore. Okay, there we go. So we're gonna get our puddle paints down. And like I said, I am using some similar colors to what she used when she did the piece that I'm inspired by, but I don't have the exact colors at all, so I kind of just tried to mix some shades that were similar. And I added in another color that she didn't use, but that is something I liked and thought would maybe go well. Okay, my mixing isn't as near, or pouring isn't near as smooth as Sarah's either. I don't know if I'm putting on enough, too much. So I've got two more colors after this one that we're gonna put down. And I will try my best to put as close of descriptions in the description below the video of the colors that these are, but so many of them I mixed more than one color because I was like, yeah, I don't really like that shade. So I added more to it. Added a different shade, just changed it up some. So I've got a ton of paint. I actually mixed my paint sitting on my floor, guys, right where I'm standing. So I've got a ton of paint around my feet because after I was done mixing, I was like, okay, I've got to get to doing this or I'm not going to have time. So we're going to stretch and see. Also, like the issue that she had, I feel like I lost a lot of this flesh tone. I know I'm going to dump a lot off too, but I really like it. Okay, so let's see. I really don't like pouring into this spot that I'm in right now. As in this basin that I'm in, because it goes all over this platform, which is where I do my spins. Trying to stretch this as thin as I can, guys. I really want to get some pearls to show up in here. I don't know if we're getting some at the top. That's good. Pull this off this bottom corner over here and stretch it back. Okay. We're gonna let it go right there for a second, guys, and just kind of see where we get pearls. I'm really hoping, I don't like this blob that kind of stretched around right here, so we'll do something right there, but I'm really hoping that we get some pearls that pop up over in this section as well. Awesome. We are getting a lot of pearls, more than I thought we would get. Okay. I'm not loving the color composition, but it's okay. We can work with this. We can definitely work with this.